Tweenie's back tomorrow. Brand new Bill and Ben on the way.
That's right. But now, Les Bob is going to help us introduce our first ever contestant and winner of Gremlin Pictures.
Yes, take a look at this. This has been sent to us by Josh Barham, who's 4 years old and comes from Chingford. It's an auto autograph, an automatic signing machine.
Wow. What do you think, Les?
Wow, brilliant. What does this knob do on the back?
Careful. If you'd like to send us your invention for Emlyn, then this is the address. It's Gremlin Inventions, CBBC, PO Box 4567, London, W12688. And you could win these prizes if you are the winner. You all right, Les?
Yeah, better now.
Excellent. Thanks. Right now, it's really new, all new.
New!
It's Bill and Ben.
New!
Bill and Ben. Bill and Ben.
It was a lovely autumn morning in the garden. The sun shone brightly, and a gentle breeze stirred the golden brown leaves on the trees. But Bill and Ben were too busy to notice. They were trying to make the garden gnome laugh. But as he was made of concrete, they were finding it quite hard.
Morning, Phil. Morning, Ben.
Scamper had a big nut in her mouth, and they couldn't understand what she was saying.
Nice day for it. Sorry, caught stuff.
Whoa!
Slow down, you two. I can't understand if you both talk at once.
Ronnie Reed.
Stop! What is the big idea? Ben! What are you doing?
What's so funny? I've just been attacked by these two hooligans, and all you can do is laugh.
Oh, Scamper, they were only trying to help. You see, they thought you'd got that nut stuck in your mouth.
What a ridiculous notion. I'm collecting nuts from the nut tree in next door's garden. I'm storing them up for winter.
Yes. Are these two annoying you, are they?
Not anymore, they're not. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important things to do. I've got an idea. Why don't you two help Scamper to collect nuts for her winter store?
I don't know. Never think of anyone but themselves, these two. Well, that's youngsters for you, I suppose. No use to anyone.
Bill and Ben said that if Slowcoach was so keen for someone to help Scamper, maybe he should do it himself. In fact, said Bill, why didn't they have a nut-gathering contest? They'd soon see who was the most helpful around the garden.
Right, you're on. Yes. Slow and steady wins the race. Good for nothings.
Well, don't you think you two ought to get started? You've got a plan. Well, it had better be a good one.
Scamper, I've got you a nut.
A nut? for me. Oh, thank you.
There'll be more where that came from. I'm having a race with those two nuisances. See who can collect the most nuts for you.
A race? But Slowcoach, they're much faster than you. They're sure to win.
Have they arrived with any nuts for you yet?
Well, no, but...
Right, I've got to fly. Bill and Ben still hadn't started the great nut race. They were playing hide and seek.
Oh, Flubber! Oh, Flubber did. Flop. Flew. A free. A flubber door. A flubber dive.
Don't you think you ought to get started? Slowcoach has been nutting for ages now. He must have collected at least five.
Ha-ha! Flabberdon!
You've got a plan?
Flabberdix! Flabberbird! A blade!
You, Tortoise, I've been watching you. Just what do you think you're doing?
I'm collecting nuts. For Scamper. This is my fifth.
While Bill and Ben carried on playing, Slowcoach carried on collecting nuts.
Not started yet.
Useless pair.
Oh, flub-a-dub.
Flub-a-dub-a-lub.
Bill and Ben needed a few things for their plan. They thought they'd find them in the tool shed.
flub-a-dub.
Oh.
The flowerpot men needed a plank of wood.
And a flub-a-dub.
And an empty paint pot.
Flub-a-dub-a-dub.
All they needed now was.
Flub-a-dub.
A flower pot.
Ooh. Oh, Scamper. Here I am again.
Oh, thank you, Slowcoach. You are a friend. I thought you said Bill and Ben were racing you to see who could gather most nuts. There's still no sign of them.
Oh, no. Too busy enjoying themselves, I expect. No sense of common decency, those two. Right. Better shoot off for more nuts.
I shan't need many more. You've collected 17, and my larder's nearly full.
Oh, really? 17, eh? I'd like to see them beat that. Flubber-dub!
Well, really? It's like a railway station in here today. All these comings and goings. What do you want?
Flubber-dubber-nuts.
Nuts? Everybody seems to want nuts today. First that Scamper, then that dreadful Tortoise, and now you two.
Bill and Ben didn't pay much attention to the bossy Rose. They knew they hadn't got much time to lose. While Ben collected nuts and put them in the flower pot, Bill began to set up the clever part of the plan. It wasn't long before Ben had filled the flower pot with nuts. Bill told him to stand on the end of the seesaw. Bill was going to jump onto the other end of the seesaw and Ben would fly through the air with the nuts all the way to Scamper's tree. Ben was beginning to have second thoughts about their plan, but he didn't have time to think of another.
Flob, flew, flee, flow!
Flop.
18.
What on earth? What's happened?
A flower pot man just fell out of the sky.
Bill tried to explain about the plan and how it had all gone wrong.
I see so.
And a pot full of nuts.
There's no point in you two going to collect nuts. I filled up Scamper's larder, single-handed.
It's like I said, slow and steady wins the race. Bill and Ben congratulated Slowcoach and went back to tell Weed what had happened.
So you see, Bill, Ben, some sometimes it's better not to play all day. Sometimes you have to work at things to... Oh, you're asleep.
And so they were, fast asleep and dreaming of another day.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and
Ben.
Wow!
Oh, that was brilliant, wasn't it? And you can see Bill and Ben, they're back next week. Bless you. Yes, Hubbub is coming up. Brand new series in just a moment. And Les Bub is our special guest today. Bless you.
Les, when you finish sneezing, can you tell us what we can expect?
Oh, loads of new adventures, different characters, but today I'm back at school and I get my bike stolen. Will I be able to face the school bully?
Don't miss it.
It's like school here.
He dresses like a Viking.
He's better than Beefcake Logan.
The wrestler on telly.
He talks like a Viking.
What have you got to say for yourself?
But is he a real Viking?
He's rather big, isn't he?
He's rather smelly.
There's a Viking in my bed. Today at 4:20 on CBBC One.
And Christopher from Southampton, bless you, has emailed. He says, it's my favourite programme and I annoy my big sister Hannah by singing the theme tune. And don't forget, you can see there's a Viking in my bed in 25 minutes' time.
Rotten Ralph is also on the way!
But right now, this is really new.
New!
It's Hubbub.
This is no ordinary city. This is no ordinary tower. This is the home of someone special. The home of Les Bub.
Hubbub.